If you're a developer and you choose not to do this, apps without verification won't work on most Android devices in the coming years. Google just announced one of the biggest changes for Android. This most likely will change the way that you can install apps away from the Google Play Store on Android in the coming years, and it's going to make Android look a little bit more like iOS. This affects more than you think, so let's get into it. Important context here, especially for iOS users who haven't used Android. On Android, you can install any app that you get from the internet. All it needs to be is a .apk file, and you just sideload it on your phone away from your regular app store, in this case, the Play Store. As an example, we have an app, it's an open source app, it's called Plexus. It's a community sourced way to review apps on de-Google devices so that people can see if the apps they normally are dependent on will work on the new operating systems they move to. All the developers behind this app need to do is just put the app together, create it. I say that as like it's easy to do, but you just put the app together, you publish it online. If you want a more familiar example, Signal, the secure messenger, actually has an Android APK. You just go on their website, you click download, and then you just click that file to install it. They want all developers now, regardless if they're even publishing to the Play Store, to have to identify themselves and register within Google's Android Developer Console ecosystem. This is literally KYCing developers, even if they're trying to avoid the Google Play Store. If you're a developer and you choose not to do this, apps without verification won't work on most Android devices in the coming years. This is all being claimed as a security benefit, which I'll touch on in a second, but Google is planning to test this as early as October of this year. In September 2026, they plan to launch this in select locations. I think they chose those locations as the locations that they see maybe the most amount of malware in the sideloading world. And then the next step is, like the article says, hazy, but Google is targeting 2027 to expand the verification requirements globally. So the goal here is to get this to be a global feature so that all developers have to identify themselves, and this comes with a lot of important implications. Just to show you guys what this looks like, to get verified, it literally says here, this is on Google's developer website, verify your identity. You'll need to provide personal details, legal name, address, email. If you're registering as an organization, you have to supply that, and you need to upload a government ID to KYC yourself. And then when you register your app, you need to provide the app's package name and the app signing keys to Google, which just out of philosophy is not something that I think a lot of app developers are going to enjoy, to have to hand over their app signing keys to Google, especially if they're actively trying to avoid the Play Store. Now, like I said, Android has been always open, and Google has been one of the companies that says, well, we can be open and secure, and Apple is the one who always goes, well, we need to lock everything down because it's all insecure, even though macOS is fully open and we don't see those problems over there. Google claims that sideloaded apps is where they see the most amount of malware, and this could very well be true. This is a very easy way for a developer to spin up a malicious app online, get people to download it, and easily use it. But this seems like a pretty radical solution to that problem that it has many other implications, which could hurt developers, increase levels of censorship, and make it much harder for people like you to get certain applications. The core justification that they seem to be using for this is that in 2023, they actually started doing this verification within the Play Store, and they did see a massive drop-off in the amount of malware on the Play Store. So they said, oh, great, that worked there, so let's just apply this in all contexts, even when we really shouldn't have any control over what developers are doing. That is just part of the game. In the Play Store, they have control, it's their store, and if someone wants to publish something online that lets you install software onto your phone, then that's their business. Regardless if this is going to make an impact, I think most people would agree there's a massive overstep there, and this is Google essentially trying to create walls around the Android ecosystem. The other thing that I'm really glad Ars talked about here is that the timing of this is very coincidental, shall we call it. There's been a lawsuit between Epic Games and Google regarding third-party app stores. I have a few notes here. It allows third-party app stores on Android. It lets other stores redistribute Play Store content. It reduces Google's control over App Store distribution. And the reason why this timing is suspicious, because Google is about to lose potentially a lot of developers from the Play Store, and they're going to lose a lot of insight. And also they're going to lose a lot of the apps that people are going to build potentially for other platforms. This policy, coincidentally, now it still requires all those app developers, even if they're not developing for the Play Store, to still register themselves with Google and still get Google's approval, because if Google doesn't like your app, they're going to block it, even if it's not coming from the Play Store. This is highly ironic because it means Google's being forced to allow people to move away from the Google Play Store and supposedly reduce Google's control, but now they're implementing a policy that gives them the most control they've ever had. And it looks like Google's just doing this to maintain control over the ecosystem. And we've been seeing Android move more and more in this Apple-esque direction. You all probably get why this matters, so to speak. Again, just to really reiterate this, privacy implications. Google's getting more control over what you can install. If a developer builds a Russian or Chinese VPN that's designed to get around the censorship in those countries, and the government taps on Google and says, hey, we can't have these apps working on Android, and Google's forced to comply, then that's when we really start to feel why this matters. Developer impact means all developers have to go through Google. User freedom means that this is another step towards Apple's walled garden approach, but over on the green side of things. And this is very much so. Even if we're taking everything Google says at face value and as fact, it's still a security versus openness trade-off. And that's assuming that we're fully believing everything that Google's putting out there about security. It's still a trade-off that should genuinely be considered. Now, one really big important question that I have, as well as many of you have been asking so far, is what about F-Droid? What about these third-party app stores that already exist? So the really important thing about this, and this is a bit of an upside to the story that I don't see discussed as much, that is really important to clear. This is only tied to Google Play services. So let's say you buy a Pixel from the Google store, or you have a Samsung device, or an HTC, Motorola, whatever you have. You are essentially running Google Play services beneath the surface of your device, and then you have the Play Store. That Google Play services is still going to be the thing that prevents you from potentially sideloading an app if it's not a verified application that Google deems to be verified. If you are running something that doesn't include Google Play services system-wide in an intrusive way, this won't be a problem for you. So F-Droid will still be fine if you're using something like what I'm showing on the screen here, any of these custom ROMs, Android operating systems, but the big problem here is that most people aren't using these things. Most people are using just regular Android operating systems that come out of the box on the phone they purchased from a cell company. And those people are going to feel this because right now, something I say all the time is it doesn't matter if you're on a regular Android device. So you don't need a custom ROM to still install a third-party app store and get started with the open source world and the openness of the Android ecosystem. You can install F-Droid right now as we speak, and I encourage you all to do it before potentially you can't, on a regular device with Google Play services, and you can start downloading apps away from the Play Store. I don't know what this means for F-Droid. Does this mean that F-Droid developers can still go ahead and be verified and we can still install a third-party app store and then, you know, everything will pretty much be okay with the exception of this constant Google that they need to please? We don't know yet. And when it comes to things that become unverified, we also don't know what that means. They use very vague wording of you won't be able to use unverified apps, but is there a way to get around that? We don't know yet. So let's talk about workarounds. First off, we have a lot of time to prepare for this. So as of right now, just get something installed. They're not going to release any update that's going to uninstall software that you have on your phone. That would be even crazier than anything Apple's done so far. So get F-Droid or get any other third-party app stores you want. Take advantage of it while you still can. It should still be around. We'll see. It's unclear. So if you're using something without system-wide Google Play services, then you really don't have to worry about this that much. But I would still push you and say this impacts everybody around you. Privacy is not just about making yourself safer, it's about making all of us safer, and it keeps us all more protected when that happens. So while you might be okay on a specific device that runs one of these specific projects here, that's not going to help your friends and family very much. So I beg you watching, don't just sit in your couch and go, well, I'm fine. Think about the people around you. Make no mistake, this is Android moving in a further direction like iOS. We've been seeing Google make very interesting decisions. They're not publishing the builds of their new devices like they used to. AOSP now, which is their Android open source project, is being developed in private, and then they publish the source code at the end of it. We're seeing Samsung disable the ability to unlock the bootloader to install third-party ROMs. So we're seeing a lot of these signs right now in the Android ecosystem that things are ready to clamp. down. While I don't think the worst case scenario will be all of those things all happening at once, at least I hope not, it's very clear that this is the direction companies are looking to move. What's disingenuous about all of it is that none of it ever talks about user freedom. They talk about security, and again, I'm even taking their own frickin' arguments at face value and believing them 100%. Even if those arguments are all true, they still shouldn't exist in a vacuum where we don't talk about what's also best for the user. Some users want freedom. They want to be able to install software, and all computers follow this model. There is no computer that stops you from downloading a piece of software from the internet. This is literally how all desktop operating systems work, including macOS. The only exception, I guess, ironically, is perhaps the Chromebook, which still allows you to run third-party operating systems in many situations. Stay informed. I'll try to keep you guys updated as best I can, and please let me know your thoughts down below, and make sure to share this video so that all Android users, even if you're an iOS user, this still is important, guys. So please pay attention, stay up to date, and share this video around if you found value in it. And if you really like what we're doing, there's lots of ways to support us. There's paid options here that you can find down below on our support page on our website, techlore.tech/support. And we also have free ways to support it as well. There's a lot of cool free things you can do. And that's really all I have to share. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time on Techlore.